Hi, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are going to guide our robots around the board in such a way that they make drawings with their tracks. Let's start from the same program that we wrote last time. You see, move forward to right, move forward to right, forward, right, forward, right. But this time, while executing the program, I will place gray tiles behind the robot to represent its tracks. Okay, let's see what happens. So move forward, and here is the first tile. Move forward again, here we are, and here is the second tile. Turn right. I don't need any new tile at this point, just because turn right is an instruction executed on the same box where the robot already is. But as the robot moves with the next move forward instruction, I have to place another tile. Move forward again, another tile. Turn right, here we are, and then we jump to the bottom part of the program, and we tell the robot to move forward again. Here it is. Move forward, another tile. Turn right, here we are. Move forward, and then move forward again, second last instruction, and turn right. Last instruction. Here we are. Now let me take the robot off the board to see the tracks entirely. As you can see, and as you probably expected, the drawing that the robot made by moving around the board is a square. It's an empty square, actually, because the robot followed just the borders, the four edges of the square, without entering into the square. Now, what I want to do now, instead of writing a program and then letting the robot execute the program to see which is the drawing that the robot leaves as a track, I will start by a drawing and try to write a program to let the robot color it. So the first example is just very simple, because starting from the square that we already have, I just add a tile into the middle, because this time I want the robot to visit all the boxes that form our square in order to color it entirely. My question is, do we need to rewrite a program from scratch, or we can slightly modify the one that we already have in order to adapt it to the new situation? I think that the second option is viable. So let's see which instructions we need to change in order to make the robot color all the tiles in the square. As you remember, move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right are the moves encoded by the first six instructions in our program. Now, let's keep executing also these three instructions. Move forward, turn right. Now, in order to visit also this tile in the middle, what I can do is executing this move forward here, but then instead moving forward again, I want to turn right and then move forward. Turn right and move forward. Okay? To double check the correctness of the new program, I can start with the tiles already on the table And in order to remember which tiles were already visited, I can do this. Just reverse them, okay? So move forward, and turn right. Then move forward again, move forward and turn right. And here we are. Move forward, and turn right. And here we are. Now move forward, turn right, and move forward. And as I keep the robot off, I have also to reverse this tile in the middle. So, as you can see, starting from a drawing, we can write a program in order to let the robot color our drawing. Now, let's try to turn this into a competitive game. Imagine that we are two teams or two players, and we wanna make a drawing together. What can we do? We can, for instance, place a tile. Let me keep these tiles off. And let me place a tile here. And assume that I'm placing this tile for the first team, let's call it the red team. And then there is another team, the blue team, for instance, that places another tile. The only rule at this stage is that any new tile has to be placed in order to have an edge, so in a box that has an edge shared with a box where there is already a tile. Only the first team can place a tile wherever it wants, okay? Now, the new team, the first one, places another tile, and the second team places another tile. And that's it. Now the two teams have to compete in order to write a program to visit all the tiles, starting, for instance, from this starting point. Okay, so as you can see, it's not a challenging task, because I'm sure that you will succeed in writing a program like this, for instance. Here it is. So move forward, turn left, move forward, and that's it. All the tiles have been visited. But what the two teams can do is try to write their programs as soon as possible, and the first team writing the program can just press start and stop the game. And if the program that the first team wrote is correct, then the first team wins. Otherwise, we can decide to check the correctness of the program written by the second team in order to let the second team win in this case. Okay, good. Now, to make it a little bit more challenging, I'm putting here another tile and setting this as a starting point. And now my question is it possible to write a program that let the robot color all the tiles, but visiting them only once? So this means that we don't want the robot to visit any box twice. This is not easy at all, because at this time, if I decide to color this part of the drawing first, then I need to pass again over this tile in order to reach this one. Okay. But on the other hand, if I'm free to decide the starting point, I can take this as a starting point, and now I can write a program that visits all the tiles. Let's see. I can, for instance, say move forward, turn left, move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right, move forward. Let's see if the program that I wrote is correct. So, move forward, turn left, move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right, move forward. Okay, it seems correct. But can you conceive a different program for coloring the same drawing starting from the same position? Let me place the robot back to the starting point. Is there any other program? Let's try to write a different program here. Move forward, move forward, turn left, move forward, turn left, move forward. Let's see if it works. Forward, forward, left, forward, left, forward. Yeah, it works. This means that there are possibly multiple solutions to the same problem, And this also means that there could be different programs to implement the same specification, to solve the same problem. And which one is better? So in this case, there is one of the two programs that is more efficient. This means that makes use of less instructions to obtain the same result. So makes use of a lower number of instructions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this one is better. Okay. Now let's keep complicating our drawing. And for instance, I could add something here and ask you if it is possible now to write a program that allow the robot to visit all the tiles just once. I'm afraid there is no program that visits all the tiles. But then the question can be a little bit different. Imagine that you can add a tile, so change a little bit the drawing in order to make it possible for the robot to visit all of them. Is it possible to just add one tile to make it possible for the robot to color it? For instance, we could add a tile at this point. And in this case, we need to choose carefully our starting point in order to be able to visit all the tiles. Imagine that we start from here. Is there a program that let the robot color the entire drawing? Yes. I am not writing the program because I would like you to write the program, but I'll just show you a possible path, a possible solution. You see, I'm not passing twice on any tile, but I'm visiting all of them. Okay. Now, the same game can be played also by using colors instead of tiles, and you can for instance start from here and then the blue team can place another, not tile in this case, but part of the drawing, so marking a new box here, and then the red team keep coloring another box, and the blue team can color another one, and then the red, and then the blue, and the red again, and the blue again, and then another red, another blue, another red, another blue, and the last one, here it is. Okay, so this is like a heart, more or less, and we can try to visit all the boxes colored of this heart without passing twice on any box. Is it possible? I leave this question open to you, and you can try to answer the first time starting from this starting point, and the second time by choosing the best starting point that you can conceive. Okay, for instance, this one. Does it make a difference? It is up to you to decide and to try. But we can also keep complicating the drawing by letting the blue team placing another one, and then the red team another one, and the blue team another one, the red team another one, and a last one for the blue team. Once again, this is a heart that you can try to cover without passing twice. If there is no solution allowing you to color the drawing without passing twice on the same box, you can also try to minimize the number of boxes visited twice with your program. Okay? So this is another challenge. In case there are no solutions that allow you not to pass twice on a box, you can try to minimize the number of boxes visited twice. Okay, let's try. Bye-bye.